Good everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, this is going to be my first video on the Lumion series. I'm going to be taking you guys through the interface of Lumion and understanding how to use it and maximize its best benefits. Okay, firstly, what is Lumion? Lumion is a real-time rendering software that is very popular in the architecture and modeling industry, along with the graphic designing and landscaping. So it has various uses, including building renders, animations, and landscape designs. So I'm just going to be taking my time to show you guys some samples of projects I've achieved with Lumion. Okay, this is just a luxury duplex I rendered with Lumion. No post-production softwares involved. Yeah, just going through it. You'll just see this is a landscape project I handled some time ago. I worked with Lumion. I can just see how good the renderings can be. Although one main factor you should know about rendering is that it's not just only about the rendering software, it's also about how good you modeled a model or a building that the rendering will come out well. So if you don't model a building very well, you can't expect the rendering to come out in max quality. So you should also take note that it's not all on the rendering software. Okay, before I just continue, please do us a favor by hitting the like button. Also subscribe to our channel for more content like this. And that out of the way, let's continue. So this is the Lumion interface. You can just get here by, if you have installed Lumion on your system, just click, double click on the Lumion tab, and it will take some time to open, but it's open. So let me just brief through what all these boxes are. First of all, this create new. Create new is basically to create a new file in Lumion. These are examples. If I just click it, example shows some preset projects that come with installation of Lumion, so you can just use it to understand the settings better. Okay, then this is the benchmark. This benchmark shows how good your system can carry the Lumion, whether your system reaches the minimum requirement for running Lumion on it. So mine is 8GB dedicated, a GTX 1070, is an old system, but hopefully we'll get a better one in future. Okay, and this is the loading to load a previously created project you have done with Lumion. This is to save and to save us. Okay, so we're just going to click on this create new. So under this create new, you'll see a series of templates. These templates are like preset environment, like this is the plain environment, this is the beach environment, this is the mountain range, this is the forest environment, this is the desert environment, and the tropical, the suburb, the winter, and the design showcase environment. So we're just going to be opening the plain for this video. Okay, we have just opened the plain project. Okay, so under this plain project, you are going to see this content library showing. This content library is where you can loading models, both imported models and Lumion based models. Imported models being foreign models from Revit or SketchUp or Blender, any software using. So to do that, you just click on this import and you can import a project, but we're not going to be doing that now. Okay, this place, if you click on nature, for example, this is the imported model tab. This is the nature tab. So if you click on nature, you'll now be able to load in some natural components, like let's say this tree now. And also along this tab, you'll be seeing this select tool, this rotate tool, and this scale tool, and this delete tool. Okay, starting from this select tool, is to move the position of a selected model. So always note that while you are using these tools, always look at where it is set at. If I set it at nature, it means I can only select natural elements in this view. For example, let me just load in an indoor model now, and I'm just going to place it too. So if I click on select now, I cannot select this tree that is a natural distance because it is set at indoor. So I can only select this chair. So going through this select, you can move it freely, you can move it vertically, you can move it horizontally, and you can type in the coordinates of for the position. You can also rotate the model, you can rotate it, you can use the, you can rotate it on this, on different axes. So you can rotate it in any way. You can just rotate it back. Okay, then this is the scale. You can also scale the model and scale it up and scale it down. Okay, and this is the delete, just to delete. You can also undo by one step. In Lumion, there's nothing like Control Z, so you can only undo in one step. So if I undo like this, I'll just show you one more thing. Also, you can also choose to be able to select any kind of model in the project. If you click on this All tab, select all categories, you just click on it and you see it move. I can move both the tree and the chair, in contrast to when I just set it at indoor models, where I can only move this chair. Okay, so you can also click on delete to delete. If you set it at all, you can click on delete to delete any kind of model. Okay, so we're going to go back to import models and we're going to load in our model. First of all, we'll be going to Revit and we're going to see the model we want to import. Okay, this is the model we want to import. Okay, this is just a duplex I did some time ago, but I'm going to be using it for this tutorial. So you just click on this Lumion export, because once you see this, for you to be able to see this Lumion tab on your Revit, you need to have installed the Lumion Revit Live Sync. You can get it for free, just search for it on your browser or your search engine. So you are going to click on this export icon and click on make sure it's at high, then click on export. Then we are going to set the location where we want to put it. This will take a little while because my saving mechanism is quite complicated. So I save properly so I don't juxtapose my files. Okay, we're going to save it under Lumion series. We're going to save it as one. Oh, let's just save it and give it another name. Let's just save it as D duplex one. Okay, that's said and done. Let's go back to Lumion. So we're going to click on this import. We're going to click on this place and click on this import, green import tab. Well, first of all, as you can see, when I click on this place, you can see this series of project. This series of models are actually previously imported models in Lumion. So once you import a model in Lumion, it automatically saves to the library. So to import a new brand new one, you're going to click on this import and go to this file. This is the duplex one we just exported, and we click on OK. And we click on good. Okay, we have successfully imported the model to Lumion. As you can see, we can move it in place. And we can move it in place and move it around. Alright, so now we have imported this model to Lumion, we can also update it from our Revit file, original Revit file. For instance, if I go back to Revit and let me delete this window here. Let me select this wall and delete this wall. Okay, now I've deleted this wall. Yeah, this is just an example. And I click on export again and replace that file. Okay, once it's through exporting, I'll just click on this Revit file I just imported and just click on this reload tab. So it's going to take some time, but okay, and we have successfully reloaded it. So as you can see, the changes I made from the Revit file has updated and it has reflected. Okay, so that is it for today's video. Please like this video, hit the subscribe button for more content like this. Also hit the notification bell to get notified when we release new videos. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.